Hey guys, Mike here with the watch list video for Wednesday, May 8th. Pretty dead day. You can see the SPY gapped up, but put in a very narrow range. But DXYZ finally paid off for us. Had it on bounce watch so many days. It doesn't look so great now, but on an intraday basis, I even said in the video last night, what I was looking for was a fairly narrow range and an afternoon break out of that range. And it broke out a little earlier than I would have wanted. I would have liked this, you know, in the final hour, but I still took it. You kind of had the cup and handle. Technically, the entry was over 1470, just a higher day break out of a tight range, right? Some of you may have been astute enough to sort of get it as it broke this little handle here. Either way, say you got 1470, it went to 1685 over the course of about 30 minutes. That was worth having on watch all these days in a row, right? And I had a really, really nice trade in that one. And I wanted to cover that because I've had this one on watch for so many days in a row. But I've got some things I got to do, so I can't hang out here in after hours. So I got to crank this video out. So if you're ready, even if you're not, I'm going to do it. SYM, nice pop today. Closing below its open, though. Maybe through today's high tomorrow. It definitely deserves a spot on the watch list. Peloton, PTON. You know what? Let me slide this over for new members in chat. We got some new faces in there. Pause the video and read that so you know what we do. It's all about day trading, and we start with the daily chart. So make sure you pause the video and read that. All right, so Peloton, interesting. I don't know if the takeover chatter or something. I don't know, going private. I don't know what it was, but topped at 419, maybe through that tomorrow. It held up pretty well. It held up better than Peloton usually does, PTON. MULN, I got to zoom in on this one. I actually really like the looks of this chart. Yeah, this big rally, 4 days, very clean pullback on lower volume. Nice pop yesterday and an inside day today. Probably my favorite chart going into tomorrow. GameStop, GME, another inside day. Definitely got some selling up in this area though, but if it can get above this area, it certainly could be interesting. So GME goes right back on the watch list. UPLD looks a little bit like GameStop, right? It's got some selling up there at the top, maybe a break through that area. TGTX, kind of a sleeper, but I like it. Had big volume about a week ago. And topped at a whole number. Topped at exactly 18, sideways for a few days, and it's starting to curl up. Certainly love it over 18, but maybe we get another setup that can get us in before 18, having 18 be the next potential catalyst, right? SMMT did break out today. I mentioned it over 5 in the video last night. It did break out and closed pretty strong. I never did get involved in this one today, but certainly worth watching for a follow-through day tomorrow. JMIA, closing way off the highs, but topped at a whole number 7, so it's kind of interesting to me. It's worth having on a chart. BIGC had something like possible buyout rumors or something, and it halted right before the close. And I said, if you're stuck in that halt, you're probably in good shape, because when that happens, when you get a late-day halt, I'll show you 5-minute candles. This happened, 10 minutes before the close. So when something volatility halts pretty close to the closing bell, it won't open until after hours, and shorts find themselves kind of screwed. And so you usually get like maybe some follow through in after hours, or at least they tend to open a little higher in after hours. This one did open and go to 7:45. Right now it's trading at 7:15. But anyway, it just makes our watch list for tomorrow. Let me go to a year out here. So that's BIGC, TOST, reported earnings in after hours. As I'm talking to you, it's trading at 25.36. It went up to 26.70. We'll see if it's still holding the gap in the morning. If it is, that'll be on our gap play watch list. Reddit, RDDT, there's the daily. They reported after hours. It went to 60.40 so far. As I'm talking to you, it's trading at 57. So with that one still gapping, it makes the gap playlist for tomorrow. Luna, I like this big pop followed by 2 lower days on declining volume. So that I'm treating it like a balance play tomorrow. And then Moderna, MRNA, just goes back on watch. Had the breakout right here over this line, right? And now you've got a 3-day pullback and seeing some buyers come in. See those little tails there. So I'm treating that again like a balance play. And that's it. I got to run. I will see everybody in the chat room in the morning. Have a great night.